Hi, today the other vintage Sony equipment still in the box. I got this in the flea market last year, if I remember. So we have here HVA200CE AC adapter, but if I remember correctly, it is more than just an AC adapter. You can see it is still in the original box. So we will open it carefully. Please read the instructions. Yes, you need to read the instructions. So, here is what happens when you use rubber bands. They are really, really bad, these things. Okay, so we have mostly a metal box. We have on the front the plug to the camera, which is a lot of oxidation on the contacts. Maybe they were silver coated contacts and they are now mostly black. Rocker power switch, little LED in a chrome mounting. Here is on the side the model number and serial number. As always, you have Sony arrows to show where you must open. We have a voltage selector on the back with a lot of wires, the mains wire of course. We have video out, microphone out, and camera remote. Where all this is going? It is going to a BNC here, probably for the video out. And in here we have two jacks, plugs, one 3.5 and one smaller one, and quite vintage shaped plugs. With this one it is written Sony on the side. Okay, so I will try to arrange the mess of wires and we will have a look inside. Okay, so I guess removing the cover is just a matter of undoing four screws. I do not remember if I did already open it. So do we have just a transformer and a power supply circuits and interconnects for the other things, or do we have some kind of signal processing electronics? No clue. It is fairly heavy, so surely we have a big old school transformer in this. I can see heat sink here on the side. So let's pop it open. Okay. So here at the back we have a voltage selector with a lot of gunk inside the heat sinks and tubes and gunk inside. We have fully enough the big school transformer. We have a main switch here with a double insulation, as you can see, quite nice touch. And it is going very far on the mains wire. Little LED mounting in here. You can see a big old school capacitor here. 7812 here mounted on this aluminium plate as a heat sink. I can see also this is quite loose, it is not really a good design by the way. And I guess I can undo two screws here and have a better look at the circuit board on here. So you can see the fit of the thing are screwed in place, so very nice quality, very thick metal also. So will it come off like so? So yes, it seems it is mostly power supply and interconnect board only, because as you can see the wires, most of the wires going to the plug are arriving here on or here. We have just a few resistors and they are going to the next set of wires going outside the box. So here we have two rectifiers. They are double diode rectifiers, so probably making a full bridge rectifier, and they are quite a nice old school Japanese design. You do not see them anymore. A square box with letterings on the top. Seems we have two. No, they are the same model number, but oddly enough, they are not the same color case. This one is brown, this one is black. They almost look like Russian design parts, quite well. We have a Rubicon capacitor here. We have a big Rubicon capacitor here. Other side, we have a fuse, which is quite frosty inside, as you can see, but it must be good. And we have, what else? We have a potentiometer, probably for setting the voltage, adjusting the output. And of course, it is made in Japan. So quite a nice design for this thing. It looks like it was barely never used, as these wires are still so this wire Zeta, I did put it myself, but apart from this, it looks fairly new. So I will reassemble this and we will just connect it to test if it is turning on or not. So it is a kind of power supply you need for the HVC 3000 camera or 4000 cameras. I have two of them, maybe either three of them, because I have a clone one. So maybe I can get one of them out of storage and just test it on this power supply. Could be interesting if I can reinsert this damn screw. Interesting. So I will be back. So I'm back. Here is the matching camera, the old trusty HVC 3000 S for SECAM, I guess. And the viewfinder is in here. If I turn the power, yes, it is turning on. It is fun because when it is switched off, you may believe it is an orange LED, but when you turn it on, it is a green yellowish. So probably a very old school LED. And I have one wire plug here, one wire plug here, and yes, they are matching. So this is good, and I have some action, in fact, in the camera. It looks like I need to make some focus adjustment. Yes, the minimal distance of this lens is a little too... Oh, I can set macro, excuse me. Here we are. So now I should be able to focus. By the way, with this old camera, it is a manual focus only. But yes, it is working. I have a picture on the screen. This horizontal vertical line you can see in the viewfinder is the light level indicator. In fact, if I obstruct the light, you see it goes to the left, and if there is more light, it goes to the right. We have a lot of we have the diaphragm here, iris setting. And we have sensibility. So the flickering is just from the camera. You cannot see it in real life. But so you know, this little box is working after I do not know how many years in his box. And it is fun, there is also flickering on this LED now. Which you cannot see at all with your eyes. So it is only a camera sync problem. And on this camera, if I remember correctly, no, you do not even have a power on off switch because it is powered by the portable VCR or by the external box, in fact. So you have very simple controls for the viewfinder, for the white balance. At least you have a white balance control. You have the zoom controls and some sound dubbing here controls. It is all. Yes, microphone input on the such. And on the side here, just the remote and the recording button. Yes, it is Secam model of camera. So this little thing is working, and in fact, as you can guess, if you do not have it, you cannot use the camera at all because of its very special plug. So it is good to have one, but so I wish I was able to test the picture on a display, but I do not have any female BNC to male RCA adapter. In fact, I had some, I remember I had some, but no way to find them. Let me check in here, maybe some luck. I have a big box here of adapters. We may be lucky, guys. Yes. Look what I found. Isn't this great? So let's set up the thing differently. I must look in the direction where I have a good distance. This must be okay. I have my blanking monitor here, which I will disconnect for you. From here, in fact. So it is a little old school, a little LCD TV. Not HD compatible, but very nice as a blanking monitor. So the camera is turned on. I must find my, yes, coax. Here, adapter, plug, and it is a pretty crappy picture. So let's make the focus first. In fact, you do not have any issue in the viewfinder. So I do not know if the signal is not compatible with the TV. Because it is Secam. In fact, I do not know if this TV is supposed to be Secam or not. Secam NTSC PAL. I set Secam. And now we have black and white. This is interesting. And a very noisy picture also. So I guess we may have a bad capacitor in the camera. Maybe. But you know what? I have another camera. So we will try to see if it is the same with the other camera. on by the magic of video editing is the other camera. It is now the RVC 4000S. So let's try it again. Same plug. And no result at all here. Maybe I need to do something about the... it was not turned on yet. And we have exactly the same thing. You can see the picture is flickering from time to time. And it is not in color, so I guess we have an issue with the compatibility of this cheap LCD TV with old school Secam. It is the way it looks. Because if I go back in auto, maybe in PAL I have some bits of color, but I don't know if they are just leaks of a signal or if it is real color. In here we have mostly stripes, so I guess the LCD TV is not decoding properly the color information, and so maybe the cameras are not have no issue. It is interesting. So this one is the RVC 4000. It is mostly exactly the same, in fact, than the other one. So there is something fun with this one. I will try to show you guys. Inside the viewfinder you have the vertical stripe for the light level, and it is all bent, as you can see. It is not a vertical line properly, but apart from this, the picture is good in the viewfinder, except maybe it is a little too bright. But so this camera has an issue with generating a vertical line for the viewfinder. It is quite weird. Okay, but the goal is reached. At least we know this little new in the box adapter is working and can be used for powering this series of cameras. So thanks for watching. Bye bye.